Gunshots were fired at a campaign gathering of presidential candidate Leody De Guzman in Bukidnon Province. ABS-CBN's Mike Navalio now on the line to tell us more. Mike?
Hi, Denise. Two were hurt when gunshots were fired at a campaign and a protest action led by presidential candidate Leody De Guzman in Bukidnon. Leody De Guzman and his senatorial best David DeAngelo and Troy Cabunegro were joining a protest action by tribal leaders against allegedly land grabbers in Quezon, Bukidnon, when they were met by a volley of gunshots. In the Facebook video, Facebook Live video by David DeAngelo, the group were seen hoisting a flag, a white flag, to show they came in peace, but soon gunshots rang out, forcing the team to drop to the ground and hide in the bushes. We know now, Denise, that at least two were actually hurt, hit by the gunfire, and they were rushed to the hospital. They are now in stable condition. We understand that Leody himself and the two senatorial candidates are safe. We are waiting if they will hold a media press conference later this afternoon to update us on what happened. But we know that this area where this incident happened is a part of allegedly the ancestral domains of the Manobo tribe in Bukidnon that is being contested. They are accusing a certain mayor of grabbing that piece of land, hence the protest action in that area. We will keep you posted about latest developments later as they come, Denise.
Thanks for that update, Mike. Now back here in the newsroom, two more presidential candidates distancing themselves from Manila Mayor Isko Moreno's call for Vice President Lenny Robredo to withdraw from the race. Former Defense Secretary Norberto Gonzalez says he was taken aback when Moreno made that plea during their joint press conference last Sunday.
There was no intention of asking the Vice President to withdraw. I think Mayor Isko may have been carried away in the heat of the question and answer, but there was no agreement whatsoever that we will ask anyone to withdraw. I'm apologizing to her because what we need is something better after the elections, whoever wins.
As for the campaign team of Senator Manny Pacquiao, they are relieved he did not make it to Sunday's press conference, given the direction the event took.
I don't believe anything was achieved by that press con. Senator Pacquiao believes that the choice is up to the people and not from anybody, any calls for others to withdraw. It's quite illogical to be for anybody to be withdrawing at the last minute. We're only 20 days away from elections, and you've gone through so many time, effort, and expenses.
For the camp of Vice President Lenny Robredo, there's no need to apologize over what happened. Her spokesperson, Attorney Barry Gutierrez, says while they appreciate the gesture, they are not bothered by calls for Robredo to drop her bid. He adds, the focus now is to strengthen their campaign more, with less than a month left before the May 9 elections.
Malaya naman ang sinumang kandidato na mag-issue ng anumang panawagan, di ba? Sa totoo lang, hindi ako na-bother at si VP Lenny hindi na-bother nung call ni Isko na, di ba, mag-withdraw ka. Di ba, paposisyon niya yun, di ba? Kung paniniwala talaga niya yun, di sige lang. Ako at kami, di ba, parang klaro din naman, di ba, na sige, may baganya kang panawagan. Respectfully, hindi kami sumasang-ayon, di ba? At tutuloy kami sa election na to. Hindi na namin kailangan magpatawag ng press conference para sabihin lang na tutuloy kami. Kasi klaro naman yun eh.
A campaign strategist says the recent press conference did more harm than good to the candidates who participated in it. Alan Herman says their supporters may even switch to other bets due to what he called a faulty messaging of the press conference. He adds vice presidential candidate Tito Soto, who is in second place in recent surveys, may have been the biggest loser.
The Filipino voter is notoriously fickle. In fact, a lot of them will change their votes on election day. So, I mean, when they're actually in the polling precinct, in their respective precinct, they will actually, some of them will even have a change of heart right there and then. There is still time to change people's minds and hearts.
And with just 20 days to go before polls open, Herman says there are still soft votes up for grabs. President Rodrigo Duterte assures Filipinos government will do everything it can to prevent acts of terrorism on Election Day. Duterte says law enforcement agencies are taking steps to ensure a clean and peaceful elections.
Kaming taga-gobyerno na naiwan, who are not candidates anyway, and who are out of job by 2 months from now, meron kaming trabaho. Ang trabaho namin is to keep order dito sa bayan natin na para plastado lahat. There must be peace, there must be law and order.
Duterte also reiterates he will not endorse any presidential candidate.
Ang pangako namin sa lahat, sa inyo, is that the reason why I refuse to choose a particular candidate to support was simply para makita ng tao na neutral ako. Even though I have a party, pero nagdistansya muna ako, except those mga rallies na kita ko na mahina yung mga kandidato sa PDP.
President Rodrigo Duterte also warning candidates against forming private armies this election season. Duterte said he will again invoke the Alunan Doctrine, which limits the number of armed guards of politicians amid incidents of election-related violence. He also threatened to have violators arrested.
We will not countenance or allow yung disorder, nor intimidation, nor violence. We will remain neutral and will see to it that the true will of the people lalabas sa election. More than 2 bodyguards would be considered a private army. So, kung sino may mga kandidato, you limit yourself. Pupuntahan kita and ask you why you cannot behave properly in this election.
The Philippine Police is working with the Commission on Elections in identifying election hotspots.